This week's Parsha, Parsha's Toldos, opens up with the words Ve'ela Toldos Yitzchak ben Avram, Avram Holides Yitzchak. The way the Living Torah translates the word Toldos, these are the chronicles, the tales of Yitzchak. And then we immediately jump into Avram A, Avram Holides Yitzchak. Why do we refer back to Avram? And then we immediately jump into the stories of the Bnei Yitzchak, the situation, the battles of Yaakov and Esav, those trials and tribulations. And the truth is, it's very hard to get a handle on who is Yitzchak. When we look at the other Avos, it's very clear who Avram Avinu is, and in fact, there's a tremendous amount of a number of prakim in the Chumash that are devoted to Avram. Yaakov as well is very clear. When it comes to Yitzchak, so we find Yitzchak is a bit more hard to get a handle on. When it comes to the Akedah, great, great moment, but yet that's Velokim Nisos Avram. It's Avram's Nisoyim. In last week's Pasha, Pasha Chayesara, so one of the dominant ideas that we have, stories that we have, is the wife, the taking of a wife for Yitzchak. But again, Yitzchak is strikingly absent. And here too, when we start talking about the toldos of Yitzchak, we jump right ahead into the story of his sons, of Yaakov and Esav. And again, who is Yitzchak? What are we supposed to learn from Yitzchak? There's a tremendous amount that can be said on the topic, but very, very briefly, if you look in Perek Chavav in our Parsha, so here we are told, really, this Perek is about Yitzchak. But even in this Perek itself, we find, for example, the Perek opens up, Vayhi Rav Ba'aretz Milvad Rav Arishna Shehaya Bimei Avram Vayelech Yitzchak Al Avi Melech Melech Plishim Gerara. There's a famine in the land just like there existed by Avram. Avram is again in the scene echoed over here. And Yitzchak goes down to Melech Plishim. And there again, you have a similar episode that his wife is taken, Imino Achosiah, just like you have by Avram, whose wife Sarah is taken. Here Rivka is taken. And then we are told there's some battles with the people of Plishtim, and they cover up, they fill the wells, the Be'eros. This is in Perek, that Psukim Yud Gimel through Yud Ches. And we are told that comes along Yitzchak, and Yitzchak, Vayachpor, Vayoshev Yitzchak, Vayachpor is Be'eros Amayim Asher Chavru B'mei Avram. Avram is again in the scene, and he redigs the wells that were now filled by the Plishtim, and Vayikra Lahem Shemos, and he gives them names. Which names? Kashemos Asher Kara Lahen Aviyam. He redigs the wells that Avram dug, and he gives them names. Which names? The same exact names that were given to Avram. Then the parak closes with Yitzchak getting the bracha, that Eretz Yisrael is going to be his, that he's going to inherit the land just like I promised to your father Avram. So you see in this parak, this Yitzchak's parak, but Avram is surrounding the scene. He's all over. The background is all the background of Avram. But the truth of the matter is, when we think and reflect upon Yitzchak's godless, so Yitzchak doesn't leave Eretz Yisrael unlike the other Avos who do. Yitzchak's name is not changed, unlike the other Avos who undergo a name change. There's a lot of uniqueness to Yitzchak as well, but perhaps his greatness, his godless, is when it comes to Avram. Avram was a dominant presence, a creative giant, an iconoclast who really forged a new direction. The first monotheist, he finds Hashem, and he forges a new path, Lechom Eartzecha, begins it all. Yaakov, if you could focus on Yaakov's greatness, it's overcoming challenges. The challenge that he has with Esav in his early years, Lavan with his sons, constant with his wives, constantly overcoming challenges. When it comes to Yitzchak, Yitzchak was not necessarily that person like Avram who was forging a new direction. He was not necessarily that visionary who had a new path to forge. The godless of Yitzchak, and perhaps his Midah of Gvura, is the concept of Mesorah. That he took the wells, not new wells, he didn't have to dig new wells. He took the wells of Avram Avinu, and he redug those wells. He gave them names, not a machadesh. He gave them the names that Avram gave them, the same exact names, the Yisod of Yitzchak, the Gvura of Yitzchak, is that idea of Mesorah, of taking the legacy of Avram. There was no need to polish, there was no need to make it greater and better, but to go ahead and take the legacy of Avram, enhance it, sure, deepen it, absolutely, and then pass it on to the next door, pass it on to Yaakov in a untainted, a perfect fashion, just as how he received it. I heard, I believe, in the name of Soloveitchik, we often want to ask if someone is religious, we ask, are they Shomer Shabbos? Are they Shomer Kashrus? The idea of being a Shomer. What is the idea of being a Shomer? You're given an object, and you're given that object to watch, to preserve. So the idea of a Shomer, he doesn't have to make it better. That's not his job. He doesn't have to build it, enhance it, make it better. The job of the Shomer is to return it to its owner in the exact same pristine fashion in which he received. This was Yitzchak, the Av of Mesorah. When it comes to the Akedah, it was a Nisan for Yitzchak as well. Avram heard the command directly from Hashem. Yitzchak, he heard the command from his father. That's exactly the idea of Mesorah. We hear from our father, we learn from our father the Torah Shebaal Peh, and then we take that Mesorah that we receive from our parents and grandparents, and we transmit that to our children.